What is going on, movie meals? Movie meals, early in the morning, Ghostbusters Afterlife trailer, here to review it, to react to it. Before we get into it, guys, become a member of the Movie Meal Patron. Like Steve, Kimberly, and Karen. Oh, I'm tired. Like Steve, Kimberly, and Karen. Go get some merch. Guys, remember to like, subscribe, share, give us a like, go hit that subscribe button, hit the bell, get notifications. Guys, you can follow us on Twitter, Letterbox, where we do reviews, and you can see a bunch of lists we make, things like that, all going to be down below. So go check all that out down below in the description. All right, so Ghostbusters Afterlife drops their official trailer. This is like the third trailer we've had, but I guess COVID, so everybody's kind of acting as if those first trailers didn't really happen. So we're here. You got any thoughts?
I don't know. Ghostbusters, I'm not too excited for this. I mean, I remember liking the last trailer enough, but Ghostbusters is a franchise that shouldn't be a franchise. You know what I mean? I mean, the movie, the first movie is like very charming and it is very funny and it does get very creative, but it never seems like it should be like trying to be invigorated as like a modern franchise now. You know what I mean? It feels like it just should stay as it was, or at least that's my opinion. And I'm also like outside of the first movie, not into like the Ghostbusters lore and the shows and anything else and whatnot, but so maybe I'm a bit biased when it comes to that, but I don't know. I'm hoping that this trailer is good, but beyond that, I just don't get it.
The first couple trailers we had are better than anything we got from that other movie.
Tell you that the much. 2016 yeah. One. Oh, well, yeah. That's
any
definitely
trailer we've
true.
Had has been light years better than that. I no. love the first two original Ghostbusters, so I just hope it's a good trailer. All right, you ready to get into it?
Yeah, let's do it.
All right, a one, a two, and a three.
You're a great mom.
I don't know.
Just watched her in The Leftovers. So now I'm much higher on this actress. She is fantastic.
She's an awkward, nerdy kid.
Maybe a new home can be an opportunity to start fresh. I just wish he'd get into some trouble.
There's still time.
What are you doing here in Somerville anyway?
We're completely broke, and our grandfather left us this creepy old farmhouse in the middle of nowhere.
Your father wasn't much of a homemaker. He could hardly keep the power on.
You're saying he left us nothing?
Well, I wouldn't say nothing.
You went with station wagon?
It's the only one that had an engine.
What is happening here?
Somehow, the town with no fault lines is shaking on a daily basis.
Maybe it's the apocalypse. Egon's been out here for a reason.
Are you troubled by strange noises in the middle of the night?
I am.
Do you experience feelings of dread in your basement or attic?
Absolutely.
Have you or your family ever seen a spook, specter, or ghost?
100%.
You guys hear that?
Something's coming.
The whole city. It's like The Walking Dead.
Go, go, go!
Closed.
All right, Kyle, what'd you think?
Well, the trailers are still good to me. Like, I think if this is a way to get like Ghostbusters fans excited. Like, it seems like they've had some good teases, and it seems like they're feeling like this franchise could be reinvigorated with this take on it, like with one of their Ghostbusters being the kids of them and all. Yeah, and the movie just looked solid. I did forget that the son of the Ghostbusters director, Jason Reitman, I believe that's who it is. I forgot that it's kind of like a legacy type movie for him. Like, he's doing it in honor of his dad, and his dad has been able to watch him direct this thing as well. So I think that aspect is kind of cool. So I will give them that. That is like really cool to see, you know, that behind the scenes kind of cool, interesting story happening. But yeah, again, I still just feel the same as I did at the beginning of this video, but the trailers are still solid, and you know, maybe this can invigorate life into a franchise and I just don't know it, but it still just doesn't really get me too pumped.
Yeah, I really like that Ivan is doing this. I don't feel like I'm very familiar necessarily with Ivan Reitman's work compared to his dad. I'm trying to think, has he done anything? Do you know off the top of your head?
Ivan Reitman is the original director.
Talking about Jason, yeah. Yeah. Sorry. What has Jason done?
I don't know. I guess we can find out. Are you looking it up?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, well,
As a director, Tully was a nice little small little independent film.
Yeah, I heard good things about that one.
He directed Up in the Air. That's an Oscar Juno. Okay, that's right. So he's made a couple little good movies here. If you're gonna do Ghostbusters, this is the way to go. It's not a reboot. It's what happens when the kids find out, you know, have find all the ghosts you've captured and accidentally let them loose. That's the story to tell. It's a story we've seen, but that's the way to do it. That's the way to handle this franchise. I love the first two. Ghostbusters for a long time has been in the big debate with fans that, like, if it had a third movie, it would be one of the best trilogies ever made, which is just always funny. But the first two are awesome. We're going to get everybody back. Wish Dan Aykroyd could be a part of this. Unfortunately, yeah. Love Dan. RIP to one of the legends.
Dan Aykroyd's alive.
Who am I thinking? That's which one of them passed away?
What was his name now? I can't believe I'm spacing on his name.
I can't believe I looked it up and just got it wrong. I meant Harold Ramis. Excuse me.
Yes, it is Harold Ramis. I knew it started with an H.
RIP to one of the legends, Harold Ramis. Everybody should be back, so it should be really fun, to the point where we're even supposed to be getting Rick Moranis to be back. Remember, he's rumored to finally be back after he's been in that commercial with Ryan Reynolds, and he's going to be in the Disney Plus show. People are like, wow, they've gotten Rick Moranis out of retirement. Sorry, I'm getting off track on the trailer here. I like the trailer. I think it's fun. It's charming. This one showed us a tiny bit more. We're going to get a lot of nostalgia, which is fine, but I hope we get a little bit of something new and unique. I don't think this needs to be a massive franchise. We don't need 15 movies with this same cast. I do like the cast. I think the little girl's really excellent. Obviously, our boy from Stranger Things. The woman playing the mom is an actress I was very unfamiliar with until I just finished The Leftovers on HBO. A hidden gem, and she is phenomenal in that show. I mean, blew me away. So now I'm way more excited to see this because I forgot she was in it. So I'm even more excited. Obviously, Paul Rudd's a great choice to kind of come in and be a nerdy little, you know, school teacher.
Yeah,
I thought the trailer was fun. I mean, I'm not jumping up off the walls, but like, you give me a good trailer, then you got me some optimism heading into the theater. So I liked it. Guys, what did you think though? Comment below, let us know, remember to like, subscribe, and share. Go be a member of the Movie Mail Patreon. Go follow us on all that stuff, Letterbox, Twitter, everything linked down in the description. Go get some Movie Meals merch. And as always, thanks for watching, Mom.
See you guys.